Dragons fight riding Revenant Seekers are filled with a fierce determination, born of a desire to protect the legacy of their people, and they will fly into the very jaws of death to this end. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint a dragon's fight in the scheme of the Revenant Seekers. Now, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and to do this, we've chosen to use grey sear. After that, we'll begin our base coats, using Corn Red, Rhinox Hide, and Corvus Black for the bulk of the dragon's fight. Then we'll be shading using Agrax Earthshade. So I'm going to take some Corn Red here onto the palette and thin it down with a touch of water. Then roll my brush up to a nice point. And then I'm going to apply that onto the head, the tail, and the wing spines of the model. Now we're going to use Rhinox Hide to pick out some of the other areas on the dragon's bite. If you're not sure which areas to pick out, you can always refer back to the box art. Now we're going to use Corvus Black to paint the antennae and also some of the claws. Now we're going to apply Agrax Earthshade on all those areas we've painted. And on the tail, we're just going to apply this into the recesses to avoid changing the overall colour of the model. And with that shade applied, we're now going to move on to some highlights. So for this, we're going to use dry brushing, and we're going to start off using Evil Sun Scarlet, then Talon Sand, and then finally Dawnstone for all the different areas. So I'm going to take some Evil Sun Scarlet here onto my paper towel, and I'm going to work off as much of that pigment as possible. Just want to leave a small amount of paint on the brush. That looks about right. Then I'm going to build that up on the model in soft layers, working on just those red areas and just making sure we only catch the raised areas. Now we're going to dry brush Talon Sand onto those brown areas. Now we're going to use Dawnstone on the antenna and the claws. With all that dry brushing done, we're now going to move on to the skin. So for this, we're going to use Morgas Bone. So I'm going to take some onto the palette here and thin it down with some water. Then roll my brush up to a point, and I'm going to use this to paint the wings and also any areas of the dragon's bite skin. With that base coat done, we're going to move on to the next stages. So we're going to use Skeleton Horde, then down with Contrast Medium. Then we're going to highlight back up using Screaming Skull. So I'm going to take two parts Contrast Medium onto the palette. Two, quick rinse of my brush and dry it off. Then one part Skeleton Horde and mix that together there. Now I don't want too much on my brush, so I'm just going to make sure I've not got too much. Roll my brush up to a point, and I'm going to apply that onto the skin and also the wings. With that done, we're now going to use Screaming Skull to highlight the veins on the wings. With that highlight done, we're now going to finish off with the eyes. So for this, we're going to base coat using Grey Sear, then apply Athematic Blue, and then finally use White Scar to dot the eye. So I'm going to take some Grey Sear onto the palette and thin it down with some water. I only want a little bit on my brush here, so just making sure to take some off. Roll my brush up to a point. Then I'm going to carefully apply that onto the eyes of the dragon spite. Apply Athematic Blue onto those eyes. Again, you only want a small amount of paint on your brush. And to finish off, we're just going to dot the eye using White Scar. When you're doing this, aim to get it into that top corner of the eye. And there we are, our dragon spite is now painted up as a Revenant Seeker. By following this guide, you can easily transfer the techniques shown to any other models in your collection. Well, that's the end of the video. We hope you've enjoyed watching and we hope you have great fun painting your own miniatures. We'll see you in the next one. Bye!